Good morning, students. Welcome to the 8th lab lecture of Python for BCA, third semester, as per the syllabus of IK Gujral, Punjab Technical University, Jalandhar. These are the programs mentioned inside the syllabus. I am going to execute the 8th program today. Previously, I completed with all the 7 programs. Compute sum of natural numbers from 1 to n number. This one is the program. To execute the program, I am using Spider platform. This one is the title. It's program number. This program. As per the syllabus of IK Gujral, Punjab Technical University, Jalandhar, it's for BCA, third semester. Compute sum of natural numbers from 1 to n numbers. Now to calculate the sum of n natural numbers, I will use for loop. Before proceeding with the program, let's understand about for loop. Suppose I am writing here like this. For I in range, inside bracket 7, print I. Let's check the output. It will print the data from 0 to 6. It means if I am writing n here, I can print the value from 0 to n minus 1. If I am writing 1 to 7, let us check the output. I can print the data from 1 to 6. It means if I am entering n from the user, n int input enter any integer value. It means if I have to print the data from 1 to n, I have to write 1 to n plus 1 here. Let us check. Suppose I am entering 5. It means I can print the data from 1 to 5. If I am writing n here, it means I can print the data from 1 to 4. It means one value is less than the final value. If I have to print the data from 1 to n, I have to write 1 to n plus 1 inside the range. Let's execute again. 1 to 5. It means first number is included and the last number is excluded. You have to write n plus 1. Now, to find the sum of these numbers, whatever the number entered by you, suppose I am writing here one variable sum is equal to sum plus I. Each time we have to add the number. But before writing this statement, I have to write sum is equal to 0. Now what is the meaning of this? Let us try to explain this one. In first step, I is equal to 1. What about if I am entering n is equal to 5? N is equal to 5. Now what will happen? For n is equal to 5, I varies from 1 to 5. when I write 1 to n plus 1. If I write 1 to n plus 1 inside range, if I write like this, if this content is there, this one, if this content is there, range 1 to n plus 1, then I can print the data from 1 to 5. In first step, I is equal to 1. When I is equal to 1, sum is equal to 0 plus 1. It means answer is equal to 1. Why 0 plus 1? Because at first step, sum is equal to 0. And value of I is equal to 1. 0 plus 1, answer is equal to 1. What about second step? Now, when I is equal to 2, sum is equal to 1 plus 2. It means answer is equal to 3. Now, why 1 plus 2? Value of I is equal to 2 now. What about the value of sum? This one is 1. 1 plus 2, that is 3. Similarly, you can add other numbers. For I is equal to 3, it means sum is equal to, now the value of sum is equal to sum plus I, and value of sum is equal to 3. I can write 3 here, and what about the value of I? It's also 3, and answer is equal to 6. Now when I is equal to 4, I can continue up to the required point. Now value of sum is equal to 6 and I is equal to 4. Now answer is equal to 10. Now what about the next value? I is equal to 5, then sum is equal to 10 plus 5 is equal to 15, like this. In this way, you can explain the contents. Now, let's execute this content. To print the sum, I have to write sum here. Now execute the program. Suppose I enter 5 here, the answer is equal to 15. This one is the sum of natural numbers from 1 to n number. Similarly, you can enter any number. Suppose I enter 123, you can find the number or sum of the numbers from 1 to 123. For that, you can write here sum of the numbers from 1 to then the next number, that is n, whatever the number entered by user, equal to, here you can write sum. Sum of the numbers from 1 to n means the number entered from user side. Let us check the output now. If I am writing 23, sum of the numbers from 1 to 23 is equal to 276. Now, some questions are there inside this program. Suppose I execute the program with a negative number, minus 12. Look at the answer. Sum of the numbers from 1 to minus 12 is equal to 0. Basically, what we have to do, we have to enter a positive value. For that, we can do something. If n greater than 0, like this. And we can control this content inside if statement, like this one. And second one, else if n is equal to 0. If n is equal to 0, then you can print as sum is equal to 0, like this. And the third condition, when n is less than 0, else if, or you can write else here, print please enter positive value, like this. You can write like this. Now you can control the data. If n greater than 0, you can calculate the value. If n is equal to 0, you can write sum is equal to 0. Else, enter the positive value if the user enter the negative value. Let's execute the program now. Suppose I enter minus 12 now. Please enter the positive value. I think this one is the valid output. Now, if I am entering 0, then sum is equal to 0. If I am entering any positive value, 13, I can find the sum of the numbers from 1 to 13, that is 91. Hope you understand the content of calculating this value, that is computation of sum of natural numbers from 1 to n numbers. This one is the program. Compute sum of natural numbers from 1 to n numbers. Thanks for watching my video.